Hi, this is Jessie Golden. Roll out your yoga mat. We're going to do a little yoga flow, yoga stretch, and take some time for yourself. So just sit in a comfortable seated position and just start to notice your breath here. Start to take some deep breaths in through the nose, out through the nose. Kind of like the ocean. In and out. One more breath here. Blink open the eyes and make your way into a tabletop position. Your shoulders are directly over your wrists. Your hips are directly over your knees. Inhaling and exhaling as you round the spine. Look up as you inhale and bring the chin to the chest on the exhale. Starting to move the body with the breath. And come to a neutral spine. Bring the toes together. Sit the weight back into your heels. Keep stretching your arms forward. Let your forehead touch the ground. Press all 10 fingers into the mat. Let the belly relax. Come back to tabletop position. Tuck your toes, lift your hips up towards the sky, and make your way into your first downward facing dog. Then just start to pedal the feet, bending one leg at a time, trying to bring the heel to the ground, maybe stretching over the top of the foot. On the other side. And then come high up onto both toes. Reach your sit bones all the way up to the sky. And then lower the heels back down. Come to the top of a push-up. Pushing the weight back into the heels, press all 10 fingers into the floor. And then slowly lower yourself all the way down, hugging your elbows into your midline. Untuck the toes, come up for a low cobra. Peel the chest up off the floor, hug the elbows into the midline. Bring the forehead down, pause. One more time, peel the chest up off the floor. Exhale, forehead down. Bring the hands back a little bit so that the elbows are directly over the wrists. Press the toes into the ground. Straighten the arms all the way up, upward facing dog. Exhale, hips up towards the sky, downward facing dog. Come to the top of the push-up, all the way through the vinyasa. Lower halfway, chaturanga, the elbows are 90 degrees. Roll over the toes, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And then begin to walk your hands all the way back to meet your feet. Keep the knees bent here. And holding onto your elbows, just let your upper body hang forward. Maybe shake the head no, let go of any tension you might be holding on to. Take a deep inhale, open up the mouth, let it out. Clasp the hands behind the back, bring the arms up and over for a deeper stretch. And releasing the hands, roll yourself up one vertebrae at a time, letting your head be the last thing to come up. Come to the top of your mat, feet together, hands at your heart. Close your eyes for a second and just set an intention for your practice, whatever it is that you need right now. Inhale, open up the eyes, open up the hands. Inhale, bring the arms out and up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come halfway up with a flat back. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come all the way back up where you came from. And bring all that energy into your heart. Again, just like that. Inhale. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, all the way up to stand. And hands at your heart.
Okay.
Moving on. Inhale. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come halfway up with a flat back. Exhale, fold forward. Bend the knees and place your hands flat on the floor. Step your right foot back, your left foot back, and pause. Lower halfway chaturanga, roll over the toes, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Raise your right leg all the way up to the sky. Bend the knee, open up the hip, do what feels good. Straighten the leg, and then square off the hips. Inhale. Exhale, you're gonna bring that foot all the way in between your hands and lower your back knee. Bring the hands to the top of your thigh. Draw the tailbone down. Lean forward so you feel a nice stretch through the hip flexor. Bring the arms all the way up. Lowering your left hand, bring your right hand all the way up. Turn your gaze up if it feels okay. Bring the arm back down. Come to a high lunge. Bring both arms up overhead, crescent pose. So the back leg is straight, that's the anchor. The front leg is bent 90 degrees. Steady breath, steady mind. Inhale, palms together, look up. Exhale, bring the hands down. Shoot that leg back and through your vinyasa. Lower halfway. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward. Raise the left leg all the way up to the sky. Bend the knee, open up the hip, do what feels good. Straighten the leg and square off the hips. Bring the foot all the way in between the hands, lower the back knee, and bring the hands to the top of the thigh. Lean forward to get a nice hip flexor stretch. Tailbone is heavy. Bring the arms all the way up. Lowering the right palm to the ground. Twist open towards your leg. Turn the gaze up towards your top hand. Bring the top arm down. Straighten the back leg. Tuck the toes. Inhale all the way up. Crescent pose. Bend deep in the front leg. Steady breath, steady gaze, steady mind. Inhale, palms together. Exhale, fold forward. Shoot that leg back. Lower halfway, chaturanga. Inhale. Exhale, hips lift up and back. Downward facing dog. Steady breaths here. Inhale, high up onto the toes, bend the knees, jump or step your feet to your hands. Inhale, halfway up, exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come all the way to rise and bring all that energy into your heart. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold forward. Jump or step to chaturanga, elbows bend 90 degrees. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Right foot comes forward. Inhale, one breath, crescent pose. Exhale, fold forward, shoot your leg back and through your vinyasa. Inhale, left foot comes forward, all the way up. Exhale, fold forward, shoot that leg back through the vinyasa. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Three steady breaths. Inhale, high up onto the toes. Bend the knees, jump or step your feet to your hands. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale all the way up to stand and bring all that energy into your heart. We're gonna do a little tree pose here, a little standing pose, great for balancing the energy in the body. So firm your left leg, your supporting leg. Bring your right foot high up into your inseam, either above the knee or below the knee. Bring the hands at the heart. If it feels comfortable, bring the arms all the way up. Turn your gaze up. And as gracefully as you came in, slowly come out. Shaking it out, switching sides. So firming the right leg, the left leg comes high up into the inseam. Hands at your heart. Don't look down because that's where you'll end up. Start to bring the arms up towards the sky. Turn the gaze up. If you fall, just gracefully come back into it. All about the attitude. Hands at your heart. And slowly release, shake it out. One more vinyasa to get down to the ground. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold forward. Jump or step to chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Raise your right leg all the way up to the sky. Bring that foot in between your hands and lower the back knee. Bring your right foot to the outer edge of the mat and bring your right arm inside your leg. So we're gonna get into a deep hip stretch. Stay there. If it feels comfortable, you can come down onto your elbows for a deeper stretch. So we tend to hold a lot of emotions in our hips. So it's important to take time to get in there to release all of that. So notice where you might be holding on to some gripping. Breathe into that space and use the exhale to let it go. Inhale, oxygen to the body. Exhale, releasing. Bring the foot back in between the hands. Straighten that front leg. Come high up onto your fingertips, lengthen the spine. Exhale, begin to fold forward over that leg. Deep hamstring stretch. Inhale, lengthen the spine one more time. Exhale, fold forward. So instead of thinking of just getting the nose to the knee, think about getting the crown of the head to the foot. Creating length. And flex the foot if it feels good. We're gonna bend that front leg and come into a single pigeon pose. So the further the foot is away from the body, the more intense of a stretch it'll be. I like to hug that foot in a little bit tighter so I get square off the hips to the front. Inhale. Exhale, begin to walk your hands forward. Maybe make a little pillow with your hands. Let your forehead come down to the ground. So this is where the practice is. Getting in there and giving yourself the time to open up. Use your breath. And let everything go. Begin to walk yourself up back where you came from. I'm gonna bend that back leg, and if you can, hold on to that foot. Get a nice stretch here. If that feels okay, you can hook the foot into the elbow, and you can push the foot into the elbow to help lift your chest up, maybe bringing the top arm up and hooking the hands. For a moment, please. And slowly release the hand, release the leg. You're gonna bring your left leg all the way around for a seated twist. Make sure your toes are facing forward. And then use your hands to lift your chest up and try and create as much length as you can. Bring your right arm up. Hook your elbow on the outer edge of your left leg and then begin to twist. Look as far as you can to the left because that's where we want to end up. Every focus has a purpose. Stay in the twist. And then just begin to turn your head back towards the room, front of the room. slowly release. And just shake it out. Come back into downward facing dog. This time we're gonna lift the left leg all the way up. Bring the foot in between the hand, lower the back knee. Bring that foot to the outer edge of the mat and both hands are inside that leg, coming back into that deep hip stretch. If you can, come down onto your elbows. Do what feels good. So you wanna find that space between pushing too hard and not enough. If you feel pain, come back. You wanna feel a sensation, and then you breathe into that area. On the exhale, open up the mouth and let it go. The release of the jaw mimics other openings in other parts of the body. So let go of any gripping. And come back up onto your hands. Bring that foot back in between your hands. Begin to straighten that front leg. Come high up onto your fingertips so you can lengthen the spine. Exhale. Begin to fold over that leg, crown of the head to the toes. I like to do that one more time. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold over that front leg. Then you can let everything go. You have to allow your body time to open up. Come back to where you came from. Bend that front leg for the single pigeon. Square off the hips to the front of the row. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, begin to walk your hands forward, making a pillow with your hands. Put the other hand in front and then let your forehead rest on top of your hands. And just let gravity do its job. Let your body be heavy. Inhaling oxygen to the body. Exhaling, okay. Letting go. And slowly come back to where you came from. This time you're gonna bend your right leg and try and grab that foot. If that feels okay, you can hook the foot onto the elbow. I'm gonna push your foot into your elbow to help lift up your chest, maybe bringing the left arm up and hooking it with the right hand. And turn your gaze up towards the sky. Steady breath. And slowly release the same way you came in. And bring that back leg all the way around for a simple twist, making sure those toes are facing forward. Lengthen the spine. Bring your left arm up, hooking it onto your right knee and twisting as far to the right as you can. And stay in the pose, just turn your head forward and then slowly release, shaking it up. We're gonna do a nice little back bend series. We're gonna do two bridge poses, and if you have a back bend practice, you can go into full wheel or Urdhva Dhanurasana. So come laying onto your back, bring your hands alongside your body, feet are parallel. Now lift your hips up towards the sky, clasp your hands underneath your back, wiggle your shoulders underneath your back as high as you can. Pressing the weight into your heels, keep your feet parallel and the chin away from the chest. Come back to your breath. Slowly release the hands, lower your bum back down to the ground. Bring the feet as wide as the mat and let your knees fall into each other and bring your hands onto your belly for one breath. One more time just like that. So coming back, bringing the feet parallel, lift the hips up towards the sky. Maybe bring the other finger in front, clasp the hands underneath the back, lift the chest up towards the sky. Chin away from the chest. Slowly release. Bring the feet as wide as the mat, the knees fall in, hands on the belly. One breath here. You can either do bridge one more time. If you have a back bend practice, bring your hands alongside your ears. You're going to pause at the crown of your head, readjust, feet are parallel, and then straighten the arms all the way up, breathing into your back. Use your breath. When you're ready to come down, bring your chin to your chest and slowly lower yourself all the way down. Now you can give yourself a big hug. Bring your knees into your chest, rock side to side. Coming into happy baby, widen the legs. Holding on to the outer edge of the feet instantly makes you happy. Rocking side to side. Bring the legs back into the chest. Rock yourself all the way up to sit two or three times. Rocking all the way back. Bring the legs out in front of you. I'm gonna end with a nice forward bend. Very cooling to the body. So bring the arms all the way up. Slowly bend forward. If you can hook the feet, hook the feet. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, folding forward. And slowly roll yourself back up. And just as we started, come into a simple seated position. Bring your hands to your heart and close your eyes for a second. Remembering your intention and honoring yourself for practicing today. Namaste.